The hippocampus, classically known to be really, really important for memory. If something happens in your life and you remember, then that's the hippocampus doing its trick. What's actually going on in the hippocampus to allow that to happen is really there are several processes. The one that we're interested in, and people have been located to a particular subpart of the hippocampus, is something called pattern separation. So if two very similar events occurred to you, but they're very, but you want to treat them very different, then you need to represent them very differently. For your everyday life and for memories, this is really critical, because if you want to remember one episode from your life that has a lot of shared features with another, then you need to represent this differently. So if you do two things with your best friend, and you want to remember those two things as separate events, even though your best friend is an integral part of both of them, you need to your brain needs to figure out how to represent those very differently, even though one most salient feature, your best friend, is common in both of them. And the hippocampus, this is one of its roles, is to take whatever is going on in your life and represent it as disparately as possible. So this is one of the challenges we face in learning how to behave as well, is that overlapping similar things in your world can require very different responses. And so that's what we were testing. Is the hippocampus critical when you have very similar features that are important and you need to separate those out? And then does the hippocampus interact with the brain systems that we know are important for learning how to behave? And is it direct activity in those structures in order to help you learn and survive?